Hi, everybody, and welcome to part two. Just to say that with this hall, that this hall is possibly used for various rituals. Now, there is light that can get in here and so forth, so maybe that's allowed for because within ritual rooms, like with the Freemasons, they control the light. And if you look to the room in Wewelsburg Castle in Germany at the tip of the spear there, that room you could easily control for light also. Here in Sydney in Annandale on Johnson Street, you have a row of houses there. They're called the Witches' Houses. And I've heard from a member of the public that there's supposedly an underground room to one of those houses, to the main one, the Abbey. I actually spoke to the owner. He denied that there was, but that may not be the case. It may be there. He just may wanted to have kept that to himself. But nonetheless, around cities, and particularly the old, within Masonic temples, but also within the old castles and bits and pieces around Europe, there will surely be these particular rooms for rituals. Now, on the subject of various groups that are sort of outside of Freemasonry, like the sort of quasi, I'll just keep it at that, like the Ordo Templi Orientis, the Rosicrucians and these sorts of things. In a way, it's all a bit of a web. In another way, here in Australia with Freemasonry, my understanding is that Freemasonry does not want the Freemasons to practice outside of Freemasonry in other orders. And if they do, they're possibly disciplined or struck off the order. But nonetheless, from my experience in talking to people, this is what happens in Masonry, is that Masons will sort of branch out from Masonry, and this comes from multiple people. I'm even familiar with a Freemason who seemed to be taking on the notion, and perhaps even including myself, years ago in a ritual completely outside of Freemasonry. That didn't eventuate. A further point is that potentially within Freemasonry may be a kind of recruiting ground in a way for orders outside of Freemasonry. And yet another point that I kind of had a realization about this myself, and I'll just mention it briefly, is that within Freemasonry there may be a certain Freemasons higher up that are sort of looking at the younger members coming through, if you will, and looking for various sort of magical qualities, if you will, and those that are more esoterically inclined to divert off into various orders. And indeed, within Leadbeater's writing somewhere, I sort of came across this notion after that also. And this is the notion of the higher up Freemasons looking more clairvoyantly at the younger Masons coming through. And by the way, just to cover myself, I'm not saying that this is a definite fact. So now let's look at the Collective 777 website, the Art Guild of the Ordo Templi Orientis Australia. Just for a moment here, you have the goddess with the third eye and so forth, the veil and the red under there and all the rest of it. We'll just scroll down for a moment. And so just briefly, you can see here this artwork here by William Blake. I'm certainly familiar with his artwork before on another regard. Witchcraft in Japan right there. This sort of stuff's worldwide and sort of goes through cultures and the symbolism and all the rest of it. And as the Freemasons say, you know, it's interdimensional. And I would suggest this is why it does breach across cultures and across continents and these sorts of things, in part, is because it's not restricted to the locality. It's interdimensional, if you will, tapping further entities and tapping further images and ways of going about portraying things and stories, etc. Here you have this the esoteric salon here with the lamassu with the heads connected right here. Just for a moment, this is from Parramatta, and you can see the heads connected here within the tree of life. So this interconnection that would be within the ritual scenario, I would suggest. But what we'll do now is we will go back up here, and among other things, we will just have a look at this retreat that happened earlier on in 2016. So you can see here the Esoteric Salon, Collective 777 and Lodge 777 will be hosting a creative retreat in West Australia. So this was at New Norcia, 30 attendees at the Old Convent. So the Old Convent is a courtyard residence tucked away in the secluded part of New Norcia Township, originally the home of Spanish Benedictine sisters. This heritage-listed building is full of atmosphere and character stretching back over 100 years. And we'll get into a bit of the history. So there'll be a bit of history, a bit of esotericism in this video. So just for your information, New Norcia in Western Australia is just north of Perth, about 132 kilometres up the Great Northern Highway. Now, New Norcia is the only monastic town in Australia, and monastic relating to monks, basically. Now, I'm reading from Wikipedia and just some more history. On March the 1st in 1846, a Benedictine mission to the local native Aboriginals was started about 8 kilometres north of what is the current day New Norcia Township. Within a year, the mission was moved to where the town is today, and on the 1st of March 1847, the foundation stone of the monastery was laid. New Norcia is named after Norcia in Italy, the birthplace of St. Benedict. The town of New Norcia has numerous buildings, 27 of which are heritage listed, many of them in a Spanish style of architecture. New Norcia has the Benedictine Abbey, which was founded on the 1st of March in 1846, once again. And it was built for the Christianizing of Australian Aborigines. So the Christianization, the brainwashing, if you will, in a way. Within the history of New Norcia, you have the Old Convent. Now, that is the place where the Collective 77 are going for the retreat today. But at one stage, as I understand, it was used for orphaned Aboriginal girls. And the town has a history of accommodating Aboriginal boys and girls. These days, just 8 kilometres south of the New Norcia Township, you have the European Space Agency. So that is a ground station, and the actual antenna there is a deep space antenna. Okay, this will wrap things up for part two and this series. I hope you found it interesting. A little bit of history in there, a little bit of occultism also. Ciao for now.